Welcome to Bethel Covenant Church. We have music, pie, and ice cream. It must be a festival, a harvest festival. We're so glad you could join us here this afternoon. My name is Joel. I am the pastor here. And this is my first time coming to a Warren concert. And to hear music, and not just a concert to hear music, but a time of worship. Yeah, with the songs that are being shared and the messages in those words for us to experience not just the gift of music, but God and His presence. And so we're glad that you're here to do that. Warren, thank you for being here. Let's welcome him as he.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Oh, my goodness. Thank you for coming today and being on time. You know, with that time change, it kind of threw me off, that's for sure. But glad you're all here and so happy to see so many familiar faces. And has anyone never heard me sing before? I'm just always curious. Is there anyone here? Okay, a couple of new ones. Thank you very much. No, Joel. Yeah, so very, very happy to be here today. As always, thank you for the invitation to raise my gifts up in praise to the Lord who gives us all good gifts. And what a great time of year to celebrate all the things that He gives to us. And we'll just celebrate in prayer and song. And if you have any requests, just forget it because I have everything lined up. In the Old Testament, under Zephaniah 3rd chapter, the Lord is in our midst. The Mighty One will save. He will rejoice over us with gladness. He will quiet us with His love. He will rejoice over us with singing. Come, let us sing to the Lord with joy. Let us shout aloud to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before him with thanksgiving and extol him with music and with song. May all our alleluias, when spoken and heard, be heartfelt thanks to thee, dear Lord, and not just lovely. And may each passing moment till the ending of our days be filled to overflowing with our Psalm 57 reads, "Be merciful to me, O God, be merciful to me. For my soul trusts in you, and in the shadow of your wings I will make my refuge. I will cry out to our God Most High, to God who performs all things for me. He shall send from heaven and save me. God shall send forth his mercy and his truth. My heart is steadfast, O God, my heart is steadfast. I will sing and give praise. I will praise you, O Lord, among the peoples. I will sing to you among the nations, for your mercy reaches unto the heavens and your truth unto the clouds. Be exalted, O God, above the heavens, and let your glory be above all the earth." Dear Father, open our eyes today to see your hand at work in the splendor of your creation, in the beauty of human life. Touched by your hand, our world is holy. Help us cherish the gifts that surround us, share your blessings with our brothers and sisters, and to experience the joy of life in your presence. This we humbly ask through Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. Provided. springtime and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in their courses above. Join with all nature in manifold witness to thy great faithfulness, mercy, that endureth, thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide, strength for today and bright hope for tomorrow, blessings all mine with 10,000 besides. Great is thy faithfulness, morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness. So much. Yeah, they don't write them like that anymore, I'll tell you. I just love those old hymns. And here's another really, really old hymn, and actually was written to another piece, but someone pulled it out, added some glorious lyrics to it. And it actually is such a beautiful song. I really love singing it for you. But the psalm that inspired it and the lyrics is Psalm 46, which it talks about God's defense of his city and his people. God is our refuge, our strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we shall not fear. Though the earth would change and the mountains shake into the heart of the sea, though the waters roar and foam, though the mountains tremble with its tumult, Selah. There's a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. And God is in the midst of that city, and it shall not be moved. God will help it when the morning dawns. The nations are in an uproar. The kingdoms totter. He utters his voice, and the earth melts. The Lord of hosts is with us, the God of Jacob is our refuge, Selah. Come, behold the works of the Lord, and see what desolation he has brought onto the earth. He makes wars cease to the end of the earth. He breaks the bow. He shatters the spear. He burns the shields with fire. Be still and know that I am God. I am exalted among the nations. I am exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. be still, my soul, the Lord is on thy side. Bear patiently the cross of grief or pain. Leave to thy God to order and provide. In every change, he faithful will remain. Be still, my soul, thy best, thy heavenly friend. Through thorny ways leads to a joyful end. Be still, my soul, thy God doth undertake to guide the future as he has the past. Thy hope, thy confidence, let nothing shake. All now mysterious shall be bright at last. Be still, my soul, the waves and still know his voice who ruled them while he dwelt below. Special man here in the audience today, and he said, "Don't do that during the service." I doesn't want to hear it, but it's Al's birthday today, and he's sitting right here in the front row. Tomorrow, that's right, that's right. I didn't call you this morning, but be ready tomorrow. He'll be in his workshop, I'm sure, and but he usually gets a call from me. So I think we should just all sing "Happy Birthday" to Al, because why not? Right? Because we're here, and I think everybody know Al. Al Hooper, yeah, Al's a good guy. Everybody, happy birthday to you. Sing it out.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Al.
Sing it out.
Happy birthday to you.
Beautiful. Oh, man, it sounded like the... Excellent, give him a hand. Wow, what a bunch of singers. That's really awesome. It sounded like the Mormon Tabernacle football team right there. Yeah, that's something. Well, and you've been married a long time, like my wife and I, Jane, and I are celebrating 1,810 days of wedded bliss, yes. And she's here today, always love to have her with me. And we know we won't get 50 years like some of you. How many have been married 50 years? That's just kind of a round. Look at that. Generally a mature crowd today. That's awesome. How about 60? Anybody hit 60? Look at that. Oh, awesome. 70? Yeah, just really pushing it now. No kidding. How many years has it been?
70.
Right on the nail. Yeah. And a big party at your house tonight? already had the party. It once was enough, and we're not all invited. Okay, all right. Otherwise, I was going to say we could come over and bring a dish to pass. That usually works really well. Wow, 70 years. Well, Jane and I just, we've been so blessed. And no, we won't get 50 years. We know that, not at our age. But we've been blessed with three wonderful grandchildren. They're 6, 3, and 1. And I'll tell you, they can keep you hopping. If I don't know if any of you have grandchildren, but they're quite amazing for their energy. And I just have to tell one story about Jackson. He said, "Aren't cute?" He was 5 years old, and Mom was on the phone with us, and he wants to always have the phone in his hand. I don't know if any others do that, but he wanted to hold it, and he's after the phone, and Mom just says, "Now, Jackson, what did you learn in Sunday school today?" And they were studying, of course, the fruits of the Spirit. And so, love, joy, peace, patience. And he said, what did the pastor say about patience? And he thought a moment. It's a fruit, Mom. He's got it down. So we celebrate every day, Jane and I, click our coffee cups together and say, happy 1,810 this morning. Because in Psalm 90, it tells us to do so. Not have coffee, but it does say, so Lord, teach us to number our days that we might gain a heart of wisdom. So this song is for all you parents and grandparents. If it weren't for kids, have you ever thought there wouldn't be a Santa Claus? Look what the Lord just brought, thank God for kids. And we'd all live in a quiet house without Big Bird or Mickey Mouse and Kool-Aid on the couch, thank God for kids. Thank God for kids, there's magic for a while. Special kind of sunshine and a smile. Do you ever stop to think or wonder why the nearest thing to heaven is a child? Daddy, how does this thing fly? And 100 other wheres and whys. I really don't know, but I try, thank God for kids. When I look down in those trusting eyes that look to me, I realize there's a love I just can't buy, thank God for kids. Thank God for kids, there's magic for a while. A special kind of sunshine and a smile. Ever stop to think or wonder why nearest thing to heaven is a child. When you get down on your knees tonight and thank the Lord for his guiding light, pray they turn out right. Thank God for kids. Thank God for kids.
And grandkids. And great grandkids. Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much. You know, I'm gonna do a song by request here. I didn't get too many requests. In fact, I always ask my good friends and my wife and everybody, and oh, whatever you do will be just fine, which isn't helpful. But I walked in today, and I got chided for doing a song last year when a young lady couldn't be here. And so she said, you're going to do it today, aren't you? It was less of a request than a demand. And I said, okay, yeah, I'm glad you're here today. So this is quite the song, actually. There's another version of this that has beautiful scripture verses to it. I won't do that one today just for time's sake, but it's an old Irish song, and interestingly enough, years ago, we used to do this song almost every night in the memories, wherever we were, we'd probably do this song, and it's an old Irish song, and we got done with it one night, and this little elderly lady comes up to me and says, if you're going to do an Irish song, you should do an Irish toast. Well, I don't know any Irish toast, so she writes down on a napkin, and I think, I do, I have it on the back of this, it's a cocktail napkin, yeah. And here's what she wrote. She said, so here's, I don't know how many Irish we have. I'll slow down for you. Yeah, that's a bad combo. So this is what she wrote. She said, let those who love us, and those who don't love us, let God turn their hearts. And if he doesn't turn their hearts, let him turn their ankles so we'll know them by their limping. I don't know. Oh, Danny boy, the pipes. Are calling from glen to glen and down the mountainside. The summer's gone and all the leaves have fallen. 'Tis you must go while I must bite. But call me back when summer's in the meadow, or when the valley's hushed and white with snow.
Thank you so much. Psalm 40 says, "He lifted me out of the pit of despair, out of the mud and the mire. He set my feet on solid ground and steadied me as I walked along. He has given me a new song to sing, a hymn of praise to our God. Many will see what he has done and be amazed, and they will put their trust in the Lord." Right now in our history, at this moment in time, probably no more powerful words than that. I wondered what to bring up and how to say it, and I struggled for words, so I went to a Jewish rabbi who wrote these words this week. "God, our strength and protection, we pray for the state of Israel in this devastating time of war, shock, and grief. Our hearts are breaking, God. We pray for the lives of the innocent civilians that have been heartlessly kidnapped. Bring them home. Watch over them, God. We pray for the lives of the soldiers who've been taken captive. We pray for their safe return. Shelter them, God. We pray for the souls of the innocent victims who were brutally slaughtered. Send comfort and strength, God, to the grieving. Send healing to the injured. Strength and wisdom to the doctors and nurses. Pray for all our brothers and sisters in Israel at this time of tragedy and crisis." The author of this next well-known and very old hymn had lost pretty much everything material in his life when he sent his family, his wife and children, to Europe on a ship which was lost at sea, and he lost his entire family. He went out to the site a while later, and these words came to him. Sing along if you know, please. "When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well. It is well with my soul. It is well with my soul. It is well. It is well. My soul." In the Gospel of John, Jesus says to you and me today, "If you abide in me and my words abide in you, ask whatever you wish, and it will be done for you. By this my Father is glorified, that you bear much fruit, and so prove to be my disciples. And as the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments, and I abide in his love. These things I've spoken to you, that my joy may be in you, and that your joy may be full. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. And greater love has no one than this, that someone lay down his life for his friends. If you are my friends, you will do what I command you. No longer are you servants, for servants do not know what the master is doing. But I call you friend. For all that I have heard from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me. I chose you, and I appointed you that you should go out and bear fruit, and that your fruit should abide, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give it to you. These things I command you, so that you will love one another. Above all powers, above all kings, above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways of man. You were here before the world began. Above all kingdoms, above all thrones, above all wonders the world has ever known, of all wealth and treasures of the earth, there's no way to measure what you're worth. Crucified and laid behind a stone, you lived to die, rejected. Took the fall and thought of me above all. Crucified, laid behind a stone, lived to die, rejected and alone, like a rose trampled on the ground. You took the fall and thought of me above all. Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe, this gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on that cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid. Here in the death of Christ I live. His body lay, light of the world, my darkness. is slain, then bursting forth in glorious day, up from the grave he rose again. And as he stands in victory, sin's curse has lost its grip on me. For I am his, and he is mine, bought with the precious blood of Christ. In Christ alone I place my trust, and the power of the cross. In every victory, let it be said of me, my source of strength, my source of hope, is Christ alone.
Something happened that I wasn't necessarily ready for or expecting. Our harvest festival turned into a birthday party and an anniversary party. Lots to celebrate. Life, milestones, love, friendship, relationship. Lots to celebrate. And in the heart of a harvest festival, and in the history of this happening here at Bethel, by the way, I've been here 10 months. Bethel has been here 138 years. Warren can't remember how many times he's been doing this every year at Bethel. Somewhere between 10 months and 138 years, I think. Probably closer to the 10 months, but lots of years. Yeah, a gift that you are sharing with us for sure. And so, harvest time to celebrate. Yeah, and to give back to God. Ever since the first humans knew that God provided for them, we're going to give back to you. So we're going to have people come forward and receive an offering. And as you are able to, as you feel led to, as you want to, give to the ministry here at Bethel. We will take that in this evening, part of our celebration of life, of who God is and the way that he provides for us. It was just this morning that I was preaching and trying to think about a way to summarize who we are and who we want to be here as a church that's existed for 138 years and looking to the future. And we want to continue to be a people that preaches and proclaims the good news of Jesus Christ. And we want to be a people that helps people. I think that has been the history of Bethel, and that is the future of Bethel, to continue to help people wrapped up in the good news of the gospel of Jesus Christ. So thank you as you give tonight. I'll invite the ushers to come forward to grab the plates, and that will be passed.
Time to celebrate the harvest. Psalm 65 has these words for us today. You, Lord, visit the earth and water it. You greatly enrich it. The river of God is full of water. You provide their grain, for so you have prepared it. You water its ridges abundantly. You settle its furrows. You make the earth soft with showers. You bless its growth. You crown the year with your goodness, and your paths drip with abundance. They drop on the pastures of the wilderness, and the little hills rejoice on every side. The pastures are clothed with flocks. The valleys also are covered with grain, and they shout for joy, and they also sing. We plow the fields and scatter the good seed on the land, but it is fed and watered by God's almighty hand. He sends the snow in winter, the warmth to swell the grain, its breezes and the sunshine, the soft, refreshing. Thank thee then, O Father, for all things bright and good. The seed time and the harvest, our life, our health, our food. No gifts have we to offer, for all thy love imparts. But that which thou desirest, our humble, thankful heart. My Jesus, my Savior, Lord, there's none like you. All of my days I want to praise the wonders of your mighty love. My comfort, my shelter, tower of refuge and strength, let every breath. Power and majesty, praise to the
nothing compares to the promise we have in you.
I just got to mention it. That was the first time I've ever sung that song. A good friend of mine said, we're doing a concert next week in Eau Claire. So if those of you that want to drive over on Veterans Day night, 6:30, we're going to do a veteran salute and also Thanksgiving and Christmas. We're going to roll it all into one. And he said, I said, you got any requests? He said, well, have you ever heard of that song called... what is the title? All Things, All Good Gifts. It's part of the text here. I just didn't write down. But as soon as Craig put it in my thought process, that YouTube thing is fantastic. All of a sudden, oh, there it is, from Godspell, back in the 70s when I was 4 years old. I think that that show came out. But anyway, a beautiful song. I just I'm so blown up. But thank you, Craig, for the gift of asking for it. It truly, truly is a blessing to me. And even when things are not as bountiful as they are this year, and even though war rages across the world, through all of that, Jesus just asks us again and again to pray. Just pray. We don't understand his ways. Ecclesiastes says, as you do not know what is the way of the wind, or how the bones grow in the womb of her who is with child, so you do not know the works of God who makes everything. 37 chapters of the book of Job are desperate, sorrowful, despair, complaining to God about pain and suffering. Job had everything taken from him. Everything. And after 37 chapters of imploring God and his friends telling him, you must have done something wrong, so the sin is upon you. And he said, no, I have done nothing wrong. I follow God. In the 38th chapter, the Lord opens up from the heavens and he says this. The Lord answered Job out of the whirlwind and said to him, who is this who darkens counsel by words without knowledge? Now prepare yourself, Job, like a man. I will question you, and you shall answer me. Where were you when I laid the foundations of the earth? Tell me, if you have understanding, who determined its measurements? Surely you know. Or who stretched the line upon it? To what were its foundations fastened? Or who laid its cornerstone? When the morning stars all sang together and all the sons of God shouted for joy, who has put wisdom in the mind and who has given understanding to the heart? I don't know about you, but that would get my attention if after that much complaining I had that sort of thing. But Job put it so eloquently. He answered the Lord and he said, I know that you can do everything and no purpose of yours can be withheld from you. The Lord asked, who is this and who hides counsel without knowledge? Therefore, I have uttered what I did not understand. Things too wonderful for me, which I did not know. Listen, please, Lord, and let me speak. You, Lord, said, I will question you, and you shall answer me. But I have heard you, Lord, by the hearing of my ear, and now my eye sees you. Therefore, I abhor myself, and I repent in dust and in ashes. I passed a home the other day. The yard was filled with kids at play. And
on the sidewalk of this home, a little boy stood all alone. His face was sweet, his face was kind, but I could see the boy was blind. He listened to the children play. I bowed my head, and there I prayed, "Dear Lord above, why must this be?" And then these words came down to me, "After all, you're just a man, and it's not for you to understand. It's not for you to reason why. You too are blind without my eyes. So question not what I command, 'cause it's not for you to understand. Now when I pray, my prayer is one. I pray his will, not mine, be done. After all, just a man, and it's not for me to understand." I said, "God, I hurt." And God said, "I know. Lord, I'm so depressed at times." And he said, "That's why I gave you the sunshine." I said, "God, my loved one died." And God said, "So did mine." Oh God, mine was such a loss. He said, "They nailed mine to the cross." He said, "I know, did I not make you? The covenant is sealed, I won't forsake you. You're not alone. Surrounds you, I know." And I said, "But God, your loved one lives." And God said, "So does yours." I asked him where they are tonight. He said, "Be at peace, my child, they are in my light." He said, "I know, did I not make you? The covenant is sealed, I won't forsake you. You're not alone, I'm all around you. My glory is revealed,
I said, God, I hurt. And God said, my child, I know. This song is also by request. Was introduced to me several years ago by a dear friend. And I'll do it for my dear friend, Jerome, who's with us today, 84 years young, and so happy to have him here with us. In Job, we also read, for the Spirit of God has made me, and the breath of the Almighty gives me life. In Ezekiel, we read, this is what the Sovereign Lord says to these bones. I will make breath enter you, and you will come to life. I will attach tendons to you, make flesh come upon you, and cover you with skin. I will put breath into you, and you will come to life. Then you will know that I am the Lord. And in John's Gospel, he says, he reports that Jesus said, peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I am sending you. And then he breathed on them, and he said, receive the Holy Spirit. I'm the only thing between you and homemade pie. I'll cut it short here, but thank you so much. Thank you for taking time out of a beautiful day when you could have been doing 100 other things and enjoying your time outside, but thank you for letting me share my gift with you. Psalm 100 says, "Cry out with joy to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before him singing for joy. Know that he, the Lord, is God. He made us. We belong to him. We are his people, the sheep of his flock. Go within his gates giving thanks. Enter his courts with songs of praise. Give thanks to him and bless his name. Indeed, how good is the Lord. Eternal his merciful love. He is faithful from age to age." And now may our Almighty Lord God, our Father, our strength, our joy, our hope, our friend, our guide, our healer, our light, our creator, our savior, our Messiah, our Yahweh, our Adonai, our Eloheinu, our El Shaddai, may that Lord of life, in his infinite goodness and mercy, his blessings, his grace, his justice, his kindness, his love, his patience, his peace, his righteousness, his truth, and his wisdom, all of which he promised you and me, shall follow us and pursue us all the days of our lives. May that Lord continue to bless you and keep us. May he continue to make his face shine upon us and be gracious unto us. May that Lord continue to lift his smile upon us and grant us his peace. For our Lord is an awesome God. He's promised to be our good shepherd. Therefore, we will not lack nor want for anything. And we shall therefore dwell in the beauty of the house of the Lord forever and ever. May we love you, O Lord, with all our heart, all our soul, all our mind, and all our strength. And for all remaining days that you gift us upon this earth, we say amen and amen. Hallelujah. Praise and bless the Lord, O our soul. Soon we'll come to the end of life's journey, and perhaps we'll never meet anymore. Till we gather heaven's bright city, far away on that beautiful shore. If we never meet again this side of heaven, as we struggle through this world and its strife, there's another meeting place somewhere in heaven by the beautiful river of life. Where the charming roses bloom forever, and separations come no more. If we never meet again this side of heaven, I will meet you on that beautiful shore. Consider all the worlds thy hands have made.
great. I see your stars. I hear the rolling thunder. Sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art! How great thou art! Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art! Forest glades I wander, and hear your birds sing sweetly in the trees. When I look down from lofty mountain grandeur and see your brook and feel your gentle breeze, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art! How great thou art! Then sings my soul, Savior God, to thee. How great thou art! How great thou art! When Christ shall come with shout of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. There I will bow in humble adoration and there proclaim my God. Great thou art, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art, how great thou art, how great thou art.
You have given us so much, Warren. Yeah, our hearts are filled. Words of hope, words of comfort, words of peace, words of thanksgiving. Yeah, thank you for doing that. Thank you. You've given me an interesting theological challenge. Where in the Bible does it say that we should be drinking coffee? It's got to be there somewhere. In the Hebrew or the Greek, Arabic coffee, it's there. It's got to be. And so we go to that now. Yeah, we go to that. Let me say a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your presence, for meeting us here tonight, for being with us throughout our lives, for the gift of music, for your word, for the words of assurance and hope and comfort and peace that it provides for Warren. Lord, I pray a blessing upon him in the future times that he gets to share. Lord, that that would go well, that people would sense you through him, and that people would meet you in what he shares. So we thank you for him here tonight and the ongoing ministry that he has. We thank you for Bethel, Lord, for that 138 years of ministry and ongoing, for the work that it has done and it will do, for you to be glorified in all that we do. Be with us now as we gather around the table, enjoying the bountiful harvest of fruit and of ice cream and of coffee and of conversation and friends. We thank you for your love. Help us to share that well. We pray in your name. Amen.